One of the strangest things about life that we often take for granted is that it tends to introduce new normals. Whether it's changing jobs, going off to college, finding success as a YouTuber somehow, or death, there are always fundamental shifts throughout our lives. But a broader question would be, what is normal? What exactly does that mean? Is it arbitrary? And if so, what does it mean especially in the context of the universe itself? Yet to some degree, the universe at large also sees new normals, such as the formation of new stars and the collisions and evolution of galaxies. But a huge question lurking in cosmology is, could it all have unfolded differently? Or even more intriguing, perhaps could the universe have unfolded better, at least from our perspective, than what it did? Could there be a more ideal universe? As far as the universe itself is concerned, no. It just exists and very likely doesn't care how or in what form it exists, unless it does, which is an even stranger question. But as far as we know, it's simply there in whatever form it took. But as far as life, in some ways, this is difficult to envision because there are many attributes of the universe that if you change them, even slightly, they do not produce a better normal. Usually, rather, the house of cards that allows for life collapses, and you're left with a very different or even hostile universe to life. Or even hostile to matter itself. But sometimes not, and it pays to remember that life in the universe is a part of that universe. It's possible that this universe may actually be as perfect as they get already, though even then much of it is still a hostile, cold vacuum, dotted with dangerous exploding stars, and only very special environments can be clement enough for at least our kind of life. But if you warmed it up, the entire universe would become a habitable zone, no matter where you are within it. And indeed, it once was this way, earlier in the universe. So here the question becomes, how did it end up as good as it did? And is it already the perfect universe? On that one, we very likely may never know the answer. It may require a broader knowledge of the multiverse, if it even exists, to answer the question, and that may prove impossible to collect data on, to say the least. How do you get data from outside your universe? An open question. But lurking in this is also the infamous simulation theory. Much has been speculated on in this topic, but interestingly, the imperfection of the universe may stand against it. Why make a simulation that isn't ideal? An open question. But that we could find what we can define as an imperfection at all may be the way of at least effectively ruling it out, if not outright so, which probably isn't possible. That which you can't measure, you can't take on in science except in speculation. But the simulation idea is this, where we essentially do not live in a real universe, whatever that might be, but in a simulation. There are many questions here. What or who, if anyone, is running the simulation? Why does it exist? Does anyone need to run it, or is it an attribute of nature? It ultimately becomes a philosophical question rather than a physical one. So within philosophy, simulation theory often takes the form of an ancestor simulation, that at some point a civilization decides to run a simulation of itself to see how things used to be, at least in a nutshell. We sort of already do this in that we do things like model the Big Bang, or at least try to, in computer programs. This involves only parts of it, an approximation at best. And there is no successful full model of the Big Bang because there still are unknown variables, for which we have no observations to go on, just hypotheses. It's hard to call these models simulations, they technically are in a sense, but they do not result in the actual complexity of the universe how it really is, just an approximation. Scaling it up would be an extraordinary task, and there actually isn't enough matter in the universe available to build a computer that could accomplish it. We appear to be unable to run ancestor simulations at the actual resolution at which the universe operates. Rather, at best, we can only hope to do approximations at very low resolution. But that only means that we can't do it. On a level above our universe, it may be possible. No one knows. But here there is an oddity. One thing that does happen sometimes in those computer modeling programs as they run, or for that matter get increasingly more complex, is that they can become corrupted through various means. Corruption can happen in computation, whether through a mechanical error or an errant cosmic ray. Yet the most complex thing anyone can really realistically think of other than multiverses would be the universe itself, meaning that it might have an infinite, or nearly infinite, amount of ways where the simulation, if it is one, could become corrupted by internal or external error, and no longer reflect an actual ancestor simulation, but a distortion of one. Here, perhaps one of the best science fiction scenarios was the Matrix movies. Here you have an AI, manifested as the architect, that can change things as needed without the perception or knowledge of those within the Matrix. They simply don't remember any changes, having no metric with which to measure that. So it was kind of a self-correcting system in that regard. Likewise for us, it seems like it would forever be an open question as to just what aspect of the universe might represent a corruption of the system at large. Well, if we can't know about a fundamental change, then we're not going to be able to measure it. Thus, science exits stage left. But one of the possibilities here are things like singularities, such as the interiors of black holes. The interior of a black hole is ambiguous because in many ways it's a region that really is no longer part of the universe, but in some way set aside from it, and unable to interact with the rest other than to gobble up anything that gets too close. Another option is the universe's very beginning. Here the Big Bang singularity actually represents the corruption of something. Some before state that indefinitely existed until something changed, and the universe was born as a result. It may be that the universe represents a glitch in the matrix of the multiverse itself. While highly speculative, the multiverse does solve the fine-tuning question about the universe. Why is it the way that it is? And why can it conditionally support life? But it doesn't solve the question of could it be better. In this case, most universes can't, and this one simply won that particular lottery. But it's also possible that this universe itself is not ideal for life, and that there are better universes that are out there. But setting aside fine-tuning in the multiverse, within the universe any sort of corruption or glitching might not even be perceivable to us. This gets into the rather spooky question of if something about the universe, some fundamental aspect, or even some event in its history changed, then would we even know about it? Would it be Marty McFly watching his photograph erase? Or would we be blissfully unaware that anything happened at all, and the new normal just seems like the old normal to us? Obviously, if something changed too much, we'd cease to exist, so it can't have changed much. But the point is, if it did, we may not know about it, ourselves being part of the universe continuum, just like in the Matrix. Obviously, science must work on the assumption that fundamental changes of this nature do not happen, and if they do, while we may not know about them, they'd result in the end of our existence if they went too far. One such idea is if the universe does not exist at its lowest energy state, and if it ever tunneled to that, it would unleash a wall of the death of everything, expanding at the speed of light, leaving fundamentally changed laws of nature in its wake. Here, extinction would be instantaneous and we wouldn't know about it beforehand, and it would be a universal extinction. It would wipe out Kardashev Type 3 alien civilizations just like it would wipe out us, unless they are indistinguishable from gods and could protect themselves from it. Or for that matter, bring it about. As the universe's extinction wave propagated, for most it would just be normal one moment and all gone the next, where even matter itself may no longer exist in a familiar, stable form. This leads to a particularly scary scenario and solution to the Fermi paradox. This would be a universal order, where many very advanced civilizations exist, but they have developed the technology needed to tunnel the universe to a lower energy state. If all sufficiently advanced civilizations knew about this and understand what could happen, instead of diplomacy ruling the universe, it may simply be isolation and hoping for the best. Never attack anyone because they have a way to nuke the universe as you do. Thus, anytime civilizations get too close to meeting, they retreat out of mutual understanding. Yet for strategic purposes, it may be best to hide their presence to avoid potential conflict. Very speculative, of course, but it's me, and it's worth noting that nuclear-armed countries do not always have much in the way of diplomatic relations. But back to changes in the simulation. It might be that there is also subtlety here on very small scales. Maybe we could detect changes on the level of the quantum scale. Maybe that's quantum non-locality or the smearing of probabilities. But again, there's no evidence for that. More subtle changes do not appear to be happening, but even if they were, maybe we would not have a way to be aware of those either. So it's best to assume that they are not happening, for lack of any evidence that they are. Yesterday was yesterday, and its events led to today in an unbroken chain of causality stretching back to the Big Bang. The timeline is preserved, and there have been no changes. but it remains that we can't actually prove that. We can just say that everything appears consistent and without time paradoxes. Asking what is normal for a universe is a tricky question because it may not have an answer. But it remains that one possibility, if one entertains simulation theory, that whatever is running the simulation has become corrupted, and what we live in is not what was intended. Rather, over time, it has been corrupted and represents a fever dream of its former self. Perhaps the environment just after the Big Bang was ideal, and the decay and entropy of the universe represents corruption. Maybe this is why any projections we can extrapolate regarding the far future universe looks harder and worse for existence than it is now. Probably not the case, but we can't really know. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently eyeing the universe suspiciously, which is nothing new for me, except this time, there's the existential crisis question of whether it's eyeing me back. I can't say I've ever thought about that. I hope not. Be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channels for regular, in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.